So if we set things up this way, we actually get some wonderful properties coming out. So here's some things that we know about this setup for zero-sum stochastic games. Value iteration works. So we can actually solve this system of equations by using the value iteration trick, which is to say we initialize these q values to whatever, and then we just iterate this as an assignment, right? We just say, equals. So value iteration works. This minimax q algorithm converges under the same kinds of conditions that q learning converges. So we get this nice, q learning analog in this multi-agent setting. The q star that's defined by these equations is unique. So we iterate it and we find it, and there's just that one answer. The policies for the two players can be computed independently. That is to say, if two different players are running minimax q on their own and not really coordinating with each other except for by playing the game, that the policies that they get out will actually converge to minimax optimal policies. So it really does solve the zero-sum game, which is maybe not so surprising because, they are trying to kill each other after all. So yeah. The idea that they'd have to collaborate to do that efficiently would be weird.
I never thought about it like that, but yeah, that would be weird.
This update that I've written here can be computed efficiently, which is to say in polynomial time, because mm-hmm. this minimax can be computed using linear programming.
Yes, of course.
And finally, if we actually iterate this Q equation and it's converging to Q star, knowing Q star is enough to figure out how to behave optimally. So we can convert these Q values into an actual behavior, again, by using the solution in the linear program.
So it's just like MDPs and value iteration with Q learning.
Exactly. It's like we've gone to a second agent and it really hasn't impacted things negatively at all. This is all the pretty much all the things that we want come out. There are some things that don't come out. For example, in the case of an MDP, we can solve these system of linear equations in polynomial time, not just by value iteration, but we can actually set it up as a single linear program and solve it and be done in linear time. Or sorry, not linear time, polynomial time. This is not known to be true in the zero-sum stochastic game case. It's not known whether it can be solved in polynomial time.
Hmm.
So it is a little harder as a problem, but it's not harder, not deeply harder, and not harder in a way that matters in a machine learning setting.
Cool.
So this is really great. So let's try to take this same approach and see if we can deal with general-sum games.
Okay.